Show, Chuck Barris.
Thank you. Welcome. I have a letter here. I like to just read this little letter. This is from someplace in West Virginia. Can't make out that postage thing here. And it says, Chuck, when you come down on that moon, we wish you would fall flat on your ugly face. And it's signed Mario and Sherry Pamenavis Pagopoulos. It says, P.S., please say our last name right. All right. Let's get right on with it. Ladies and gentlemen, here comes Latasha Black. Celebrities. This lady brings with us today some good news and some bad news. The bad news is that she found a gray hair. The good news is it's on her chest. Welcome, JP. Oh, excuse me, microphone. Welcome, JP Morgan. I love her. What do you think of Latasha?
Oh, Natasha, you get down on your knees and get up again and get down and up and down and up and down.
Didn't she describe that well? A nine. Before show business, our next guest worked as a kosher Chinese restaurant. It's the only place in town where you could get a mugu guy pay a matzah, served by a dentist from Encino. Isn't that a role? Ladies and gentlemen, Anson Williams. What do you think, all bubs, Anson?
Well, I tell you, that was better than a porno movie.
Woo!
Wow! Well, you've gotten awfully risque in your old age. I don't know, another 10, Todd. Besides working as a performer, our next guest also has a profitable sideline. She sells day-glow dance pants to midgets who have a Tinkerbell fetish.
Uh-oh!
You gotta think about that one, though. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Patty Andrews.
Too much to kill. Honestly.
Chucky, baby, I got news for you. She could really bust up any show.
You know it.
I'm telling you. I give her a 10. I think
there you go, Tosh. That's 29 points. You bet. Natasha. I love Natasha. She's a nice girl. High school. How's your finger? Little thumb? Little thumb. All right. In case she doesn't succeed here, our next act can always go back to her day job where she was a professional udder. Are you ready, hon? Oh, you are so cute. Oh, this girl can sing. Renee Scott.
Looking back on when I was a little nappy-headed girl. And my only worry was the Christmas was would be my toy.
What do you think of Renee Hansen?
I think she's a very, very special lady, a 10.
See that? That rotten kid gave you a 10. Patty?
Oh, I'll tell you something. If she doesn't get a recording contract, she should form her own company. You're great, honey.
Look at that. That's not fair. Oh, no. I don't see what the Lord says. Hey, Jay?
10 for the band and 10 for Renee.
Oh, that's a big old team. Thanks a lot. All right, it's time now to bring out a lady who was born in the year 1920, or as the Chinese so graciously put it, in the year of the Yuts. Ladies and gentlemen, where is she? Oh, there you are. Are you ready? Ah, this girl is smitten with a show business bug. She hopes that maybe this she can start a whole career. Ladies and gentlemen, Kay Woodward. Oh, Patty, what do you think of Kay Woodward?
Oh, if Kay just gets that beat, she's going to be another Ruby Keeler, I'm telling you. She's okay. I gave her a 7.
A little 7, Kay. Jay, what do you think of old Kay?
I just love to see red flop all over the stage like that.
Oh, she's so cute. That's an 8. Hanson, you rascal.
I think she's Shirley Temple in disguise. A 7.
A 7. See that? You have 22 points. Thank you, Joe. It is so cute. This is okay. That's your little stuff. Yeah. Oh, we'll be back for more stuff. Right in. Here comes the guy who has done our show before and is really, really good. This is not a rated act. This is just for our own fun. It's good to have him back, Dave Little.
Words I have to say may well be simple, but they're true. And if you give your love, there's nothing more that I can do. Love is the me.
It's good to see you again. Let's have a nice hand. A nice old hand today, Dave. There you go, Dave. Dave has a couple of cute kids that drive around a van. He's a nice guy. After seeing this next guy, Zach, I get the feeling he's the kind of person who would make an obscene phone call and then try to reverse the charges. But then again, I guess, yeah. So we'll move right along, ladies and gentlemen. Here from Valparaiso, Indiana, where they have the tallest basketball players in the country, is J.C.
Well, there's a place down in Hollywood where the people are kind, though the air is no good. It's the Gong Show, and it's on NBC. There's Chuck Bear's telling month-old jokes while J.P. Morgan's always scoring low. Such a fine way to gain my fortune and fame. They scheduled me to perform my act after the softest in the world toilet paper ad. Well, I tuned up my six string and got ready to wail. Well, I played the blues like I knew I could, but you know that I never really understood why they hit that gong before my second verse. Well, I'm really glad they all got a laugh, because I'm stuck in a city without any cash. Done hocked my guitar for a bus ticket back home. And on the road back from where I came, well, I've still been dreaming about fortune and fame. Sang the Gong Show Blue.
All right. Oh, good old JC. That was good. That was fine.
Hey,
JP, what do you think of JC?
I think he's named wrong.
Eight. Anson.
The Messiah's arrived. Eight.
Another eight. Oh, we're coasting along at a nice pace. Patty.
Well, he didn't mention my name in the song, but I gave him an eight.
Hey, JC, it's good to have you. Let's have a nice hand for JC. Goodbye, JC. Say hello to everybody in Valparaiso for me. Hey, here's the Gong Show proverb of the week. Remember the words of Betty Crocker, who said, "You can't eat your cake and have me too." Take a milk.
Good morning, Fletcher.
Ladies and gentlemen, in case they don't succeed, here's our next act and go back to their day jobs where they were professional tree stumps. Oh, shut up. All right, now, here comes the Toe Jam Band.
That's a gift from loneliness. There are blues. That's a gift from pain. Blues when you're lonely, but you're finally lonely. Blues that are hard to explain. Now there are blues. That's a gift from waiting. But the meanest blues there be. Blues that I got on my mind. Blues that are the very meanest kind. That's blues my naughty sweetie gave to me. Play it. Thank you. treat he gives. That's who's my naughty treat he gives to me.
You did it. Anson, what do you think of this old band here?
Well, I think about a 9.
A 9, that's a good score. Patty Andrews.
Oh, I think they got everything and they sing too. You know, I give them a 9.
Another 9. J.P. Morgan.
I like the way they rushed into the ending there. That was real good.
Another 9. 27 points for the Toad Jam. Nice to have you on the show. A nice band, a Toad Jam band. Wait a minute, what's going on back here? Oh.
Now that's a band.
All right. Oh, little moonshine. This next act is a guy who, in my personal pick, is the person most likely to choose cod liver oil over Pepsi in one of those hidden taste tests. He really knows his stuff. Oh, wait, you see, this is the last of a dying breed. Here's a guy that just wrote a little love song for his girlfriend. Boy, you don't have any more like that. Jeez. Here he is, Scott Vam.
I know you and me know love, and love is happiness for you and me. But I know that you are for me, Sherry. I know that you are for me. I know we will be happy and free in our life. Yes, we'll be happy and free in our new life. Like the birds and the bees and the flowers and the trees and the moon up above. Everything's called love. Everything's called love. Like I know you, so will you.
It's just not room for a romantic.
Anyways.
Ah, you're a good sport, Scott. Why did you do that, you rotten kid?
Does it need an explanation?
No, I guess not. I guess he's right. It doesn't. But in any case, it's been nice doing business with you, Scott. Romantics, they just disappear. Bye.